poverty in Uganda today has become rampant. 30%, as I told you before, of the population in Uganda today are living below the poverty line. And this is so unfortunate that these people are the youth. And these are the people who still have some time on earth. So apparently, if the government does not wake up and help the youth out of poverty, we shall remain poor in our country. Apparently, though, we blame the government not to, you know, doing to their best to see to it that we chase poverty out of Uganda. But even as the youth have not done to our best, youth don't want to do bad jobs, want to do office jobs. Those who graduate from the universities also looking for office jobs. They are not job creators. They are job seekers, which is too bad. Even someone has graduated for the last four years, but is still looking for a job. He can't create their own job. So I don't know what we are going to do. The government has to help us. We need to help ourselves, and it will be on each and everyone's initiative to fight poverty out of their families. Since 1990, people have stayed poor. The government has not done to the best. So the government says that they have introduced many schemes to, you know, help people out of poverty. Things like Bonaba Gagawale, they have put loans for farmers, but these are also so hard to get. People don't have access to them though they are there. There is a lot of corruption everywhere. The offices, people don't leave. People don't want to leave their offices. When he's leaving, he's bringing their children. So I think to do poverty out of Uganda, we must put term limits for the politicians. Even those who are in the offices, they put the age limit and make sure that even the youth down, those who are qualified, also get the chance of working in those offices. For it is too bad, those who are in offices, they are aging, but they don't want to leave. They're just cropping the money, they're taking everything to their families. This has put us behind, this will keep us behind. And we need to do our best to see that we fight poverty out of Uganda. Can I watch some part in Uganda where you find people sleep on soil? People sleep in glass houses. People don't have to eat. People eat one meal a day. People don't dress up. People are desperate. People have lost hope. Some of them have even committed suicide. And this is too bad. The government has to help us to fight poverty out of our country, you know, attract more investors to make businesses or to make companies so as we can get jobs, and also change the education system of Uganda today, because seriously, our system in Uganda today, the education system is not bad. It is too bad, for it is training people to become job seekers, not job creators, and this is too bad. It has been since the late 60s that it is the system that is still going on. The government has not changed. Those who are going to technical are also perceived in the perspective of being failures in life, which is too bad. So I'm urging the youth out there who are listening in, who are seeing, who have gotten the chance of seeing this video and all the project, to, you know, it will be on you to fight poverty out of your life, not the government. Though the government has to do something, but we also have to do something. Thanks. Those are my names, Sanga Charles. Respect Macquarie University, and respect goes to everyone out there. Love you all.
Hay una cosa segura, es nuestro amor. Tú vives en mí y yo en ti. Thank you.